So they shipped me from different holes to another. The serial count came from when I was in a hole. They had me in one hole where I couldn't flush my toilet. This is deep. So the officer didn't like me. So what he did, he ain't flushed the toilet. So what I had to do when I do all my stuff, I used to have to burn it. You know, burn everything. And then somebody brings some water and then I flush it. So I stayed in that hole for 30 days. And then I said, you know what? I said, I can't get no books or nothing. That's how I had to count the cereal. Every day I counted that. That's why I never forgot that count. And then I started breaking down time. And then I read about Frederick Douglass, of how Frederick Douglass had to fight the cats to eat. And how he had to, when the master threw him the newspaper, he had to read. So I had, my mind was back. And then when I read other stories where guys was in solitary confinement and couldn't handcuff and had to write with they tongues. And I complained that I ain't have no shoes until I met the man ain't had no feet. So I had to read all about these people. What makes the great great? Say, if I had 8 hours to chop down the tree, I would spend 6 hours sharpening my axe. Then my wings start flowing. I say, whoa, what's going on here? The building starts shaking. And the next thing I know, they said, Earl Best, that was my name. Ready and out with everything. You going home. And that's how I got out. So they sent me to a drug program, State versus McKinley. I said, cocaine made me rob banks. And they went with it because what's good for the goose is good for the gander. It's a constitutional right that says the 14th Amendment. Probably a lot of y'all heard about it now through Obama. Remember when they were telling him to use the 14th Amendment? But he backed up because he's so humble. That's why I couldn't be no politician. Excuse me, that was a Freudian slip. You know, that's why I couldn't be no politician.